This episode of D News is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way. You know what they say, the wetter the better. And that's true in the hunt for extraterrestrial life. But where else is water in our solar system besides Earth? Hey guys, Julia here for D News. We keep searching for liquid water on other planets because we think it's a key ingredient for life as we know it. But maybe we're wrong. Amy talked about how life might look on other planets in another video. Check it out, there's a link in the description. But tell Mulder to rejoice. Recent research found strong evidence of liquid water on other celestial bodies, adding two new candidates to the list of potential hosts for life. In the 1990s, researchers found some strange magnetic readings taken from NASA's Galileo spacecraft of one of Jupiter's moons, Ganymede. They theorized that a layer of thick, salty water was the best explanation. Now, new images from NASA's Hubble Space Telescope has the best evidence for it. The research, published in the Journal of Geophysical Research, Space Physics, looked at images from the moon's magnetic field. Ganymede is rare in that it's the only known moon with its own magnetic field. This field rocks back and forth whenever Jupiter's magnetic field changes. This rocking motion allowed scientists to estimate how much water might exist on the Jovian moon. They estimate an ocean 10 times deeper than Earth's underneath a thick layer of ice, which might make it inhabitable to life. But wait, don't get too disappointed, there's more water! A recent study published in the journal Nature found evidence of hot water flowing on Enceladus, one of Saturn's moons. Liquid water was long suspected on the moon. In 2005, the Cassini spacecraft captured images of water plumes spewing from the surface. But this new study analyzed tiny rock bits from the moon and found them filled with salt and silica. Silica is so similar to quartz and sand, which are formed in hydrothermal vents, that the findings suggest hot water is currently flowing on the moon. Hydrothermal vents on Enceladus would be a huge discovery. A lot of scientists think that life on Earth got its start in deep-sea hydrothermal vents. If these vents exist on other planets, well, they'd be a good place to look for extraterrestrial life. Other celestial bodies might have water too. As far back as 1997, NASA has thought Europa, another moon of Jupiter's, has a giant ocean. Images captured from a flyby of the Galileo spacecraft suggested as much. But the water might be trapped beneath a thick layer of ice, which some scientists say is bad for biology. Another popular candidate for extraterrestrial life? Mars! It's no secret that Mars has icy polar regions, but scientists have wondered for a while now whether or not the planet was wetter in the past. New research published in the journal Science suggests that 4.5 billion years ago, the red planet might have had an ocean 450 feet deep. But the truth might still be out there. So what do you think? Is wetter really better? Let us know in the comments below. While you're at it, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here for new episodes every day of the week. This episode of D News is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.